Hey everyone, Shingu here, back after a very long time. It's been a while since I've done any type of video, and even longer still since I've done a face video. So this will be an interesting experience for me to try and get back into it. Today I'd like to share a little bit of a story that I've told a few people who are close to me or know me a little bit better. The story that I'm going to share today, while familiar, will also have a little bit of introspective and more of my thoughts as time has gone on regarding that story and how it relates to the video today. So I first came online with the handle Shingu Amito back in 2011, and that was the same year that I actually started college. And the name Shingu Amito actually originates from an intensive Japanese course that I had taken in the first 4 semesters of college, which actually led to a Japanese minor, a minor in the Japanese language. And during that time, in the very first couple classes, we were figuring out what names everybody will be calling each other, because obviously some names can't be fully translated into the Japanese language. And so for me, the name that my two teachers, one who was based in the US and one who had actually come from Japan, had settled on was Shingu Amito. And I like the name a lot, so I decided to roll with it. And when I created my DeviantArt, around the same time actually, I think in 2011 or sometime around there, my memory is a little fuzzy on this, but definitely after I got the Shingu Amito moniker, I decided to make that also my online presence name. And the rest is kind of history. So from 2011 to 2023, it's about 12 years. Maybe a little less than 12 years if we're going by exact dates. But it's been a long time. And even before my debut as Shingu Amito on any platform, really, I was going by, this is no longer my account. Somehow one of my friends owns the account and it's not me anymore. But I used to go by the name Justified Ranger. I don't know what I was thinking. Oh, I do know what I was thinking. I had played the Pokemon Ranger game for the Nintendo DS, and I absolutely loved that game. So naturally, I decided to incorporate it in my very first YouTube handle. I made that when I was like 13. So, but I didn't post any art really to that account. I tried doing some Pokemon stuff, but I didn't have a proper capture card or even like a mic to actually record anything. So I just had like this old video recorder that my dad got me for Christmas 1 year, and I had video with no sound. Different story, but that's where my beginning started. So actually the story for me starts when I was 13, but 18, 2011 was the time at which I had come online as Shingu Amito. And it's impressive to look back and realize that I've been online with this handle for 12 years. It's been a really It's been a really nostalgic experience, kind of just sitting there and realizing that I've been online for 12 years. And I think when that moniker started getting used for me, both to refer to me in real life and also to refer to me online, it was sort of like at this perfect point in time where a whole bunch of things had come together. I had left my home. I had begun dorming on campus. My first year of college was on campus dorming. I was in a new environment. I didn't know the lay of the land. I didn't know the rules. And I had really the most freedom in my life at that point. Freedom in the sense like I had nobody telling me, like I didn't have my parents telling me or suggesting me things, which they usually do because my parents are quite supportive. And they, of course, wanted to give their 2 cents whenever I was making a life decision. But in college, in that first year, that was all me. I was making all the big moves, so to speak, aside from the fact that I was going to college. And so being in that space with this new name, it kind of like mentally gave me the ability to kind of develop what I believed at the time to be the new me, to reinvent myself from the person I had been for the last 18 years and become a new person, a person closer to the ideals I aspired to. Now, what are those ideals? Well, my favorite anime, for anyone who knows me, this is not a surprise. My favorite anime is Gurren Lagann. And one of the most inspiring characters in Gurren Lagann is Kamina. And Kamina was a very boisterous, loud, in-your-face kind of guy, but he was also full of heart. And he was really, really good at taking the lead and making connections with people. If you remember me from 2011, won't be a lot of people, but if you remember me, you'll notice that a lot of my personality and a lot of my interactions kind of had that at the core. I was very big on reaching out. I was very big on engaging with people, socializing. I didn't just want to be an artist. I wanted to be an artist that was connected to others. And so half the time I would spend doing art, the other half the time I'd spend interacting with people. This was very apparent in the DeviantArt days, especially. And so it's almost like being Shingo Amito allowed me to remove myself, the person I was in real life, from the equation, come with a blank slate, and redefine kind of how I am as an individual. And I find this super interesting because a lot of the stuff that I had done in this time, I would not do today. Nor would I have done before I became Shingo Amito, because my default, like the identity that I am, my personality is very introverted, actually. I was quiet, kind of still am quiet. Unless I know you, then I open up a lot more, but typically speaking, I'm quiet. I am not the first person to jump up and get into a situation. I'm not the leader type. I usually like staying in the background a lot of the time just because I don't like the attention on me. I am awkward socially. I wouldn't say I am debilitating in this regard. I can manage in day to day. And obviously I have a day job where socializing is a big part of it. So, I've gained experience over the years with being able to maintain myself in a social situation. But primarily what I've noticed is that my maintenance is saying as little as possible and, just trying to be like cordial as much as possible with another individual or group of people that I am talking in front of. So it's really interesting that like that base me, like from before my Shingo Amito days began and even up till now, actually still exists on and maybe never actually went away. And the Shingo Amito name, moniker, whatever you want to call it, avatar, personality, that kind of like felt like a layer on top. It kind of felt like for a long time, like I was trying to live up to be this Kamina-like individual in reality and for other artists. And that's not necessarily a bad thing. I think reinventing or adding layers to your personality isn't necessarily a bad thing. But it can sort of skew how you view yourself, what your identity is. And I've been thinking a lot about this, and I've been thinking that the Shingo Amito phase of my life is over. I think I gained a lot during that time. I gained connections. I gained experience. Like I ran a podcast for a couple years. I worked on podcasts with several people in my life. That was a fantastic experience. And I also did a lot of art. I met a lot of people. Some people I still value their opinions and critique to this day, obviously. I got connected with a lot of the people that inspired me initially, which was really cool. A lot of the old guard of YouTube, if you're familiar. And it was just a really good time for me, and my motivation was pretty high during that time. But that phase of my life is over. So as I said, 2011, I started my moniker as Shingo Amito, my avatar, if you will. And it is 2023, 12 years later. I am 30 years old, and my views on a lot of things have changed drastically based on how I have experienced life, based on how I deal with life, and based on the fact that I still pursue art. The art I pursue has not really fundamentally changed, but the way I pursue it has changed, and the way art integrates my life has changed drastically over the years. And so I've found myself at 30 years old on this platform still, because I never really had it in me to give up YouTube, but I didn't really know what to do with YouTube. And I'm kind of thinking to myself, I don't need to be Shingo Amito anymore, because even though those experiences were valuable, and I think the Shingo Amito phase of my life will always be a part of me, it is not actually me. My identity is very different. Like I mentioned, I have a lot of traits and perhaps flaws that you don't normally see because the Shingo Amito presentation is very different from me. So going forward, I think my main aim with this channel is to get back to the roots and actually make it a sort of record, to make it a collection of pieces, a story, if you will, about me and my journey with art. And that means there's going to be artistic elements to this channel. That does not necessarily mean this will be an art channel, at least not in the traditional sense of what an art channel usually entails these days. So, with that being said, my real name is Amit. You pronounce that U-H, Myth, M-Y-T-H, with the hard T-H, not like a soft th, but that. So, Amit, that is my name. But for those of you who cannot pronounce it that way, because that is very culturally inclined, it's Amit. So that is my real name. That is what I will be going by on this YouTube channel. And I will see how that goes, because the other truth I've kind of come to, like, over the many years, over the 17 years of doing art at this point, and still aspiring, is there is no distinction between like my artistic life and my life. They're kind of one and the same. And the longer I keep treating them as two separate entities, I think the worse it's going to be, both for like my mental health and my identity, but also for the sake of the progress I want to make and what I want to actually get out of making art. Or get out of being creative. Like, we all pursue things for a reason. So I have a reasoning for why I pursue art, and I want to continue working towards getting to that goal. So this video really is just me kind of saying goodbye and thank you to Shingo Amito, and to kind of talk about how I'm gonna move on from here. And the answer is just to be more genuine, just to be more me. And you'll get more of Amit, however you want to say it, as time goes on. I am committing to making as many videos as I can. I'll have to see what the frequency is going to be like, but this is my plan for now. So that's really all I got. There will be art interspersed, maybe, throughout art videos, time-lapse videos like you've seen before. But the content I want to do going forward is very, like, varied and nuanced. There's different things I want to dabble in, so they'll all have an artistic bent, but expect to see many different types of things going forward. Anywho, I'm rambling now, but thank you for watching. If you did, I appreciate it. I am going to have fun with this because ultimately, at the end of the day, the other thing is I find YouTube very fun, and I'm glad to finally be jumping back into it after about 2 years. So I think it was the last time I made my last videos, or maybe even three at this point. I don't know. Time, it's relative. But anyway, I'll talk to you guys in the next video, and gals, of course. Have a good one. Stay safe, and I'll see you later.